Hey guys, it's Dan, your host of Your Dance Reviews, and today I'm back with another Walking Dead Season 4 review. This one is going to be for The Walking Dead Season 4, Episode 15, the second last episode of The Walking Dead Season 4. This one is, of course, Walking Dead Season 4, Episode 15, called Us. So, this episode for me was a really good, cool, interesting, emotional, amazing, action-oriented episode. It was a really cool lead up to a finale. Now, I would say though, honestly, in retrospect, this is probably my least favorite lead up to a finale. And I don't mean that as this is a bad episode. I actually love this episode. It's just that compared to some of those awesome, you know, Better Angels or This Sorrowful Life or Try, or, you know, even East, you know, from season six, or, you know, even Worth from season eight with the death of Simon, I would say that this one is worse than pretty much all of them. So, this is the worst lead up to a season finale. However, this is a really awesome episode either way. So, let's start the reviews. So, we pretty much have I would say, a really just kind of put together. Now, because you have three groups in this episode. You have Glenn's group, you have Daryl's group, and you have, Joe's group, Claimers or whatever. And then you have Rick and Michonne. However, Rick and Michonne and Carl, honestly, it's very short what happens between them. It's like literally one scene and then they're gone. So I really feel like they didn't even need to put that in there, to be honest. I felt like that scene was kind of like time spacer. But again, maybe that's just me. So, so we start off the episode. You've got Glenn and his group. You've got a sequence with Eugene and Tara as they're talking about video games. And Tara just really does not, she just doesn't care. So you have a scene between Tara and Abraham House, like, you know, what do you do with when the mission's over, you know? Then it kind of just cuts to Eugene talking to Tara again. And then you've got Glenn, who sees the Maggie sign and starts running as he smiles as we roll into the intro. So I thought that was a really cool opener for an episode, definitely. So he finds out Maggie's actually alive out there. So, you've got, of course, the sequences with Daryl and that guy, right? And he finds the rabbit. And I did like it because, you know, they both shoot. He's like, what are you doing? You know, and it's like, that's mine. No, it's mine. And Joe cuts it in half, gives one, you know, piece to the other. Daryl's like, there is no rules anymore. You know, he's like, claimed. One more claim. It's how you, it's how you mark, you know, it's how you mark everything, how you call everything, you know, one more claim, you know. So Daryl's just like, well, easy enough, you know, and he's just waiting to just get out of there pretty much, you know. So Joe's just like, you know, well, are you with us now, but you ain't soon? And Daryl's like, yep, you know. So just some dialogue scenes between Joe and Daryl. I love this one, though, when Joe's like, he's like, you cat person, Daryl? I love them, vicious creatures, you know. Hey, and I'll tell you, and this is true, ain't nothing sadder than an outdoor cat thinks he's an indoor cat, you know. So I like that comment because that really does sum up Daryl a little bit, you know. And also, when you look at the Alexandria story arc that happens in season 5, it really does, look back at this. So I like that scene quite a bit. So you've got the sequence with the candy bar, just kind of checking in with Rick, Carl, and Michonne, just fun scene with the train tracks pretty much. You know, Rick's like, this might go on a while, maybe we could speed this up, you know, as they're like trying to balance on the train tracks. So this is the kind of stuff I mean. Like, there's just kind of like these little small scenes, you know. It's not like a This Sorrowful Life or any kind of episode like that. This is actually a pretty relaxed episode for the majority of it. But anyway, you've got, you know, this might go on a while, maybe we could speed this up. And they share their candy bar or whatever, and, you know, Michonne tries to hide it and that kind of stuff. They share, and then, you know, they keep going, I guess. So, we'll have to assume that when they keep walking along the train tracks, they find that little camp that they're in, and, the next episode. So that's cool. So anyway, you've got Glenn that gives the ride gear over to Eugene. Just Abraham with some of his jokes, he says, you know. So yeah, so just Abraham, some of his lines he has, you know. So really cool stuff. But anyway, so you just... Just some dialogue here with the, you know, I'll give you G my right here, right here, right now. They actually go to all the way to the tunnel, but they actually split up, and Abraham's group keeps going. And again, very weird, because they're brand new, and they show us, like, literally 10 minutes of just them. So, very, very different episode when it comes to that. Fleshing out those three characters. And, you know, you've got Eugene, who is, you know, in the van or whatever, and Abraham's taking a nap. And I love it, because... He's trying to nap, and all of a sudden, Eugene, like, you know, with the car or whatever, like, the seat just, like, falls right into his face, right? And he's like, you know, what are we doing? Why did we stop? And he's like, he told me to stop. You don't stop. You never stop, you know? And she's like, I know the rules. The rules never, you know, if you know the rules never stop, you know? And Eugene's like, guys, you know, and apparently we have to assume it's Maggie, Sasha, and Bob. So, anyway, so you've got Tara and Glenn who go in there. And I like how Tara's like, no matter what happened, it was nothing as, you know, as bad as what, you know, he did to that old man or whatever. So, that is something right there I did like. So, you've got the sequence where she's like, leave me behind, just leave me behind. They're killing the walkers, and it's really, this is probably the best part of the episode where they all shoot, and then, you know, you see Maggie come through, and they reunite. So, they do reunite, finally, and, you know, after all this time, they get to see each other again. So, that was pretty cool, I guess. You know, it was a decent part. Would I say the highlight of the episode? No, I'd say the terminal scene at the end was. But, anyway. So, they're in the, you know, they're in there, and they're talking about, you know, the cure tomorrow. We're going to the end of the line, then Washington. So, they're going to go check it out, pretty much. And again, just some dialogue here. You don't need a picture of me, you never will again. So, they burn it. You've got, Daryl and Joe who, you know, Daryl's, you know, they pretty much kill off one of the, you know, the same guy that, you know, was hunting before. They kill him off, pretty much. Joe's just like, I saw him do it. He's like, you let him? He's like, hey, he wanted to do it, I let him, you know, you told the truth. You understand the rules. He doesn't, you know, it's like, looks like you get the head too. So, yeah, he just doesn't like Daryl. He was jealous of Daryl, pretty much. So, they, you know, teach him all the way, so to speak. So, that was kind of cool. Wow, is that really it, though? Because, I don't know, like, I like this episode, but I always remember this episode being something where it's like, there's not much. Maybe it's just me, but for leading up to a finale, there isn't much. There really isn't. They saved a lot for the, you know, really... really amazing finale. So, I don't know, it was a good episode. Of course, you've got the sequence at the end there, which, yeah, so you close out, you've got another theme song at the end, which I would say fit. This one really fit with the sequence. So, you've got, they go to Terminus, you see Terminus for the very first time. Hi, I'm Mary. You guys have been on the road a while. Let's get you settled and make you a plate. Welcome to Terminus. You know, so creepy because you know, now that you've seen the other episodes, you know that this is just so misleading. So, overall, what I thought about this episode, I really thought it was cool. Could have they done more? No, I don't think so. Because, I mean, you could say that they could have, you know, I don't know. I don't know what it is, just something about this episode. They could have put something else, you know? I really think they could have. Like, they could have, I don't know, maybe add some more action, because there was a lot of dialogue in this episode that doesn't push the story forward too much, you know, like the candy bar scene and stuff like that. You know, I'd say Glenn and Maggie being reunited, them seeing Terminus, and, you know, that's... You know, Daryl being with the Marauders. That's pretty much it. You know, that's pretty much the standout stuff from this episode. There's not much. Cool episode, though. So, to rate this episode of The Walking Dead, episode 15, Us, I'm going to have to rate this one a decent score. You know, however, I'm going to put this one as a 8.6, you know. I would put it higher. However, I think they could have added more. However, there's not much you could do with this kind of episode, you know, with the three groups. So, I thought it was pretty good. You know, decent episode. Can't wait to review the finale, though, because the season finale is one of my favorite, like, finales of pretty much any show. So, I really love the season 4 finale, so can't wait to review that. However, can't wait to finish up season 4. We got one episode left of The Walking Dead season 4. Thank you guys for watching this video, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.